Okay, let's have a look at some more advanced features. So we are going to look at Cubase plugins and inserts. Now we open the channel editor again, click on the E button, and now what you see is that on the left side you have insert slots, and that is where you can put plugins. Now you see that now the default Cubase equalizer is turned off. But you can turn it on and use it in combination with any inserts that you add. But we will leave it turned off for now. Okay, now you can click on that that slot, and then you will see probably a menu like this. And you see that there are also equalizers available as a plugin. So you can select a specific equalizer plugins, and each of these have their own properties and advantages and disadvantages. But for now, let's select the graphical equalizer, which you may also be familiar with. So you see 31 bands, so 31 frequencies that you can now manipulate just by dragging, boosting or cutting specific frequencies. And on the top, if you click on this preset thing, then there are predefined presets for example the vocals that we are editing right now, so that might provide you with a good starting point, and then you can still adjust according to your liking. So then you can play with and without EQ. So let's start with the EQ. Kinda love it, kinda crazy. And if you want to disable the plugin or bypass it, then just press here the bypass button, and then it will be bypassed. Kinda stupid because I'm in the deep end. Kinda love it, kinda crazy, kinda stupid. Now it's difficult to hear any real difference because we did not do a lot of change. So the changes are actually quite small, but you can do of course much more boosting. But something that you have to watch out for every plugin, is that you don't get clipping of your signal, so that you get distortion. And that may happen if you boost a lot with this plugin or with other plugins. So let's just play it again. Love it, kinda crazy. Now you hear that it is now distorting it. The meter also goes into the red, so the signal is getting too high, and you can solve that by decreasing the output level a bit. Kinda stupid 'cause I'm in the deep end. So that's what you have to watch out for. Okay, so now we have added an equalizer. Let's go back to the channel editor. So that is this one. You can also bypass it here. So that is also okay. But let's add another plugin, for example, pitch shift. And let's do the pitch correction, just to demonstrate a completely different plugin. And with this plugin, you can change the pitch of the vocal. So we are editing the vocal. So you can, for example, increase the transpose here a bit. And there are other parameters that you can change. We will not do that now, but now if we play the clip again. So then you see that the pitch has increased. So the this was original. The blue bar is the new pitch. Okay, and let's have a final one. Go back to the channel editor. We insert a third plugin, for example, a delay. Let's take the stereo delay. We open it by clicking on it. And then you see you get this delay. You can again select a preset or change the parameters yourself. Let's take huge delay and play again. Kinda love, kinda love, kinda crazy, kinda crazy. So now you hear that there has been an echo added to the vocals, and you can change the amount of delay and all kinds of things you can adjust by using these parameters. So just play around with that. I will not discuss what they are all doing in this video. But this is how you use the different plugins. And there are many more available, as you have seen. So distortions, analyzers with different types of meterings, different types of filters, etc. So just play around with it. You can bypass them individually or all. You can also move them around just by clicking on it with the mouse and drag them to a different slot. You can move them back if you want. So whatever you you prefer. So you, now you can add yet another plugin if you want, etc. So this is how you work with the different plugins. And if you have opened the mixing console, it is probably on your screen. So you can open that by F3. If it is not open, then you will get the mixer with the different faders. But also in the mix console, you will see the insert slots and the plugins that you have just added. And also here you can bypass them. You can also bypass the inserts globally here. So there are always different ways of using these inserts and manipulating them. Okay, thank you.